Hello from Slide Nerd and hello from Weebs. What's up folks? In this vid, I'm going to talk about the third way of handling button clicks. Now this is using an interface variable. Before I start showing you anything in Android, I want to go to Java and revise some specific things over there. So let me switch to NetBeans for a second and show you what I mean. Alright, so here in NetBeans, I just have a dummy Java application. There is an interface I, there is a public void work method. As you guys remember, this is an interface, so methods cannot have bodies. And then I have my public class, inside which I have my main function, right? So if I want to make an object of, say, this interface, I want a class that implements. Normally, what would I do is, normally I would say implements, then I'll say I. At this point, this will give me an error. I'll say insert code, I'll say implement method, then it will say work. I'll select that option over here, click generate, and bam, this is what happens, right? So this is a long step, and then here, if I want to make the object, I'll simply say vivs, then I'll say Java string programs, v is new, vivs, Java string programs, right? And then that will be done, and then I'll say v.work, right? So remember, my goal over here of showing you this was not how Java works, but think about this. Just to call this method v.work, I had to do so many things. I had to write this, I had to implement this, then I had to make an object over here and everything, right? This is all very stressful, right? I mean, it's unnecessary. A lot of boilerplate code written over here for nothing, right? So to simplify stuff, there's an other way. Actually, you can simply call this method, you know. There is no need to make an object, no need to implement, nothing. So let me show you that. I'm gonna remove this implements, I'm gonna remove this override, and I'm gonna certainly remove this complete object. Now take a look. What we need is, we need to override this method, right? So remember, so far you have seen classes or interfaces defined at one point and then objects made out of them. But here's my question to you guys. Can you make an object and at the same time define it? This is the question. So if you guys see, you can actually do that. You simply have your interface, right? You say new I. Now remember, interfaces cannot be instantiated in Java, right? So if you say new I, you have to also define the method work inside it. For that, you open your braces, right? And then you say public void work inside, and bam, you're done, all right? And you put a semicolon at the end. Now what is this new weird piece of code you guys are seeing? This is what is called an anonymous inner class. First of all, I want you guys to notice something. New I is like an object, alright, but at the same time, this entire bracket you see over here, you're defining this method, public void work, just the way you would normally define inside a class, right? But remember, there is no reference to this, you cannot refer to this, so it's an anonymous inner class, right? And you can also say something over here, right? Say system.out.println, something like that, and bam, work. Right. So now if you notice, this entire thing is the object, right? That is how things work. This entire thing is the object. It's defined and created at the same place. So if you guys notice, if you remember, the syntax for calling a method is object name dot method name. You can actually put a dot over here and call that method work. And take a look, Control S, Shift F6, it runs, right? So the advantage of this, you can simply copy paste this entire code, make another object like that, and here you can say hello to work instead of work. That means each object can be customized in a different way using this syntax. So now if you guys run this Control S, Shift F6, it says work and it says hello to work. Now remember, you cannot do this in the other way, right? Because normally you define the class, you define the method. Once it was defined, then objects were created based on that. But here, each object, as you guys notice, has a different behavior, right? You can customize it. And this is the basic concept for Android. This is one of the ways you make listeners, alright? So if you go ahead in Android and see, take a look. I have my main activity, extends activity, alright? I have my onCreate method. But here, instead of making a class implement the onClickListener, I simply make a reference of the onClickListener and I say new onClickListener. In short, I'm actually defining it at the place where I'm going to use it, alright? So here I say new onClickListener, bam, public void onClick, and inside that onClick method, I write whatever I want and I put a semicolon at the end. And now, I can simply set my onClickListener to vivs. Now remember, there is one more step. You can actually go ahead, you can remove this vivs variable and copy paste everything. But before that, let me actually go to Eclipse and show you how this works. So instead of saying all this, I directly make the object and I say new view.onClickListener, and then I override the onClick method, and then I make a reference by saying onClickListener o is new onClickListener. So what I have done, I have done nothing great over here, right? I have simply directly instantiated the interface and defined the method right at the point where it's used. Now I can simply go here, set the listener by saying alright, and that will be done, because what it needs is an object of onclick listener or a class that implements the onclick listener. Now remember, behind the scenes, what Java actually does when it sees this is create an anonymous inner class that implements the onclick listener on your behalf, right? Because you have not written anywhere, think about that, you have not written anywhere that this implements onclick listener. You have simply said new onclick listener blah, and you have defined the bracket, you defined the method inside it, and you put a semicolon in the end, right? So this being said, let me actually go and run this. If I select this over here and I run it at the top, so here I have my button. If I say click here, and bam, again it works. So what happens when you button click, your Android sees that O is the object who is responsible for handling an on click. Alright, now where is O defined? O is defined right over here inside this, in this on click method. This method is called when your button is clicked, and this code runs, right? So this is one way. Now you can go actually one more step ahead, and let me show you what that means. I won't use this reference variable at all. Now remember, this is an object, right? If you remember, we could simply put a dot over here and we can call any methods on that, right? For some reason that's not working right now, but in Java you guys saw that over here inside the NetBeans file. So that being said, I'm gonna take this entire piece of code, Control X, I'm gonna remove this O inside and put this inside, right? So this is what an anonymous inner class is. You said button dot set onclick listener. Inside the bracket, you needed an object that implements the onclick listener, and this entire thing which you have written is actually the object, right? You have actually created it by saying new onclick listener. At the same time, you have defined the method inside and you have defined the code for it, right? So this is how your anonymous inner class works. So I hope you guys have understood this. Don't worry if you didn't figure this out much. In my Java playlist, I'm gonna be making a detailed vid on inner classes and anonymous inner classes, so you guys can definitely stay tuned and check that playlist out. I promise you that will be the most detailed video you'll ever see on inner classes in Java. So that being said, the fifth one is very simple. You have seen the fifth method already. It's the Android onclick attribute. Alright, so if you guys haven't seen that, you can check in my playlist where I have talked about the Android onclick attribute. If you guys like what you saw, please subscribe to my channel, comment, let me know what you think about this. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys later. Have a nice day.